Welcome, everybody, to the 2023 Holliston Trivia Bee. I appreciate your coming out tonight to support the Holliston Foundation for Education. We have a 20-question trivia game tonight. We're going to start by giving you the first five categories. You've got little score sheets at your tables there with a pen if you want to write down the first five categories so you know what's coming. Here they come. Question one, category toys. Question two, television. Question three, music. Question four, consumables. And question five, our first bonus question of the evening, the category is names. Names. Toys, television, music, consumables, names. All right, here's how we play our game. We're going to ask you to bid 1, 3, 5, or 7 points on the first four questions of each round. Please use each bid only once. You can use your score sheet there to keep track of your bids. Use each bid only once. Every fifth question is a bonus question, has its own separate bidding system once we get to that. We're going to ask you to use your whiteboards. You'll see that each table has a whiteboard and a dry erase marker. We're going to ask you to write your team name at the top of the whiteboard. Leave it there for the duration of the game. And underneath your team name, you'll be writing your answer and then your bid. And you'll walk up and you'll show it to our scorekeeper. This is our scorekeeper to my right. That's Monique, our scorekeeper. Let's give her a little hand. Welcome her. She's truly a delight. So what we'd like you to do is to bring your answers up on the whiteboard with your bids underneath. And we will tabulate the scores that way. No small pieces of paper this year. We're going to remind you that the music provides clues to the answers. We'll play two small, short little song snippets. And it might be the artist, it might be the song itself. Something in the song is a clue to the answer. We explain it afterwards so you get a hang for it. We're playing tonight for the top prizes that include some gift cards for the winning team. And I believe there is also a second place prize, which Heidi will describe later on in the evening. So let's begin. Question one, the category is toys. What toy construction system was invented in 1992 by Joel Glickman? Its basic parts are made from polyoxymethylene plastic. What toy construction system was invented in 1992 by Joel Glickman? Its basic parts are made from polyoxymethylene plastic. We played a song by Patsy Cline called Fall to Pieces. There certainly are a number of pieces involved. We played a song called Come Together. The correct answer is Connex. Connex. Question two, television. Here's our television question. Fittingly, on what object do the letters AR appear in the logo for the PBS series Antiques Roadshow? Fittingly, on what object do the letters AR appear in the logo for the PBS series Antiques Roadshow? Okay, question two, television. Fittingly, on what object do the letters AR appear in the logo for the PBS series Antiques Roadshow? We played Crosby, Stills, and Nash singing Carry On, Aerosmith's song Toys in the Attic. The correct answer is a trunk, a trunk. Question three, music. Here's our music question. What instrumental pioneer is the only person to be included in both the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and the National Inventors Hall of Fame? What instrumental pioneer is the only person to be included in both the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and the National Inventors Hall of Fame? We played Adagio for Strings. We played Elvis Costello's song Less Than Zero. Les Paul was the correct answer. Les Paul. Question four, consumables. Here's our consumables question. What popular consumable is manufactured by the Ferraro Company, headquartered in Alba, Italy, and was first introduced in 1964? What popular consumable is manufactured by the Ferraro Company, headquartered in Alba, Italy, and was first introduced in 1964? Question four, consumables. What popular consumable is manufactured by the Ferraro Company, headquartered in Alba, Italy, and was first introduced in 1964? We play Jimi Hendrix, Purple Haze, Eurythmics, Sweet Dreams. The correct answer is the delicious chocolate hazelnut spread, Nutella. Question five, names. It's our first bonus question. You will discover that there is only filler music. There are no song clues. I'm sure you won't need any music to help you out. The category is names. Here's the question. According to the website babycenter.com, what were four of the top five most popular girls' first names in 1958? According to babycenter.com, what were the four of the top five most popular girls' first names in 1958? We'll go from the top one to number five. Number one, Mary. Number two, Susan. Number three, Linda. Number four, Karen. And number five, Patricia. We get a score update through five questions right now. Here's our score update through five questions. The team Queens have 10 points. Yes, and they brought their fan club with them. The Stagecoach Trailblazers have 15. The Goats have 16. The Visitors have 22, that's first place. And the Friends of Holliston Trails have 14. All right, categories for round two. Here we go, question six, art. Question seven, animal kingdom. Question eight, science. Question nine, world geography. And question 10, our next bonus question, popular songs. Art, animal kingdom, science, world geography, popular songs. Here's question six in the art category. At the website thesaurus.com, what compound word is the most relevant synonym for the word mosaic? At thesaurus.com, what compound word is the most relevant synonym for the word mosaic? We played Neil Diamond singing about his blue jeans, which often need to be patched. We played Loverboy working for the weekend. Patchwork is the correct answer. Patchwork. Question seven, animal kingdom. Here's our animal kingdom question. What's the more common two-word name for the arachnid, also known as a harvestman? All right, question seven. Animal kingdom, what's the more common two-word name for the arachnid, also known as a harvestman? And we played George Michael singing Father Figure. That was Burton Cummings singing a song called Stand Tall. The correct answer, the Daddy Long Legs. Okay, there you go. All right, question 8, science. Here's your question. Fill in the 3 blanks. The 2019 Nobel Prize for Chemistry. I'm sorry, I'll continue. At least 5 points. I'll begin again. Fill in the 3 blanks. The 2019 Nobel Prize for Chemistry was presented to M. Stanley Whittingham and Akira Yoshino for their work in the continued development of the blank, blank, blank. Fill in the 3 blanks. I'll read slowly. The 2019 Nobel Prize for Chemistry was presented to M. Stanley Whittingham and Akira Yoshino for their work in the continued development of the blank, blank, blank. We played 3 song clues at the end there. That was George Harrison and Friends, Plug Me in the middle. That was Highway Star, a fast vehicle reference. That was Deep Purple. And then we played at the beginning, that was Nancy B. Heathley on the organ playing a song called Charge. Nancy B. Heffley, excuse me. She was the stadium organist in Los Angeles Dodgers games for 27 years. That's not the answer to the question. The answer to the question is the lithium ion battery. Question 9, world geography. Here's the question. Through what 2 countries does the Ganges River flow before emptying into the Bay of Bengal? All right, question 9, world geography is the category. Through what 2 countries does the Ganges River flow before emptying into the Bay of Bengal? We played a song by the band Big Country called Big Country, reference to India. Our second song clue was a song by Led Zeppelin called When the Levee Breaks. It was a reference to the often flooded country of Bangladesh. Question 10, popular songs. It's a bonus question. We're going to ask you to bid between 2 and 10 in even number denominations. Half of your bid will be deducted from your score if your answer is incorrect. One of the 2 opportunities to lose points in our game. This is the first one. Please bid between 2 and 10 in even number denominations. Half your bid is deducted if your answer is incorrect. Popular songs. Here's our question. What song released on October 29th, 1994, hit number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 in 2019, thus setting the record for the longest trip to number 1? What song released on October 29th, 1994, hit number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100? In 2019, thus setting the record for the longest trip to number 1. That was Lindsey Buckingham singing Holiday Road. The Flying Lizards singing Money, That's What I Want. The correct answer, Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas Is You. Now we have a score update through 10 questions. Team Queens have 19. Stagecoach Trailblazers have 40, that's second place. The Goats have 38. The Visitors still in first place with 47. And the Friends of Holliston Trails have 26. All right, categories for round 3. For round 3, we're using even-numbered bids, 2, 4, 6, and 8. Use each bid only once. Question 11, U.S. states. Question 12, business. Question 13, sports. Question 14, human anatomy. And question 15, our next bonus question, famous people. All right, question 11, U.S. states. Round three begins. Which U.S. state has the highest percentage of land managed by various jurisdictions of the U.S. federal government?
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Question 11, U.S. states. You have 30 seconds, please. Question 11, U.S. states. What U.S. state has the highest percentage of land managed by various jurisdictions of the U.S. federal government? That was the Gap Band singing, "You Dropped a Bomb on Me." The state is known for its nuclear weapons testing sites. And we played a song called "Let It Snow" by international mega recording star Regis Philbin. That was a joke. Let it snow because the name of this state translates to the word snowy in Spanish. Nevada is the correct answer. Nevada. Here's our business question. Within 3 years, either way, in what year did the Coca-Cola Company introduce New Coke? It was considered a major failure and was discontinued in 2002. Ladies and gentlemen, we're announcing a bonus on this question only. Correctly name the artist and get a point bonus. Name the artist of this song, earn a 1 point bonus. Doesn't hurt to guess. Just write it down on your whiteboard. In what year did the Coca-Cola Company introduce New Coke? It was discontinued in 2002. Considered a major failure. We played a couple of filler songs there. The Coca-Cola ad song. Played "It's a Mistake" by Men at Work. That was not the question for who was singing the song clue. It was the first one only. The second one was too easy. The correct answer to the question, 1985. So we accepted 82 to 88. So let's quickly move to question 13 in the category sports. Born on July 5th, 1985, who was the most recent solo female recipient of the Sports Illustrated Sportsperson of the Year? It was in 2019. Born July 5th, 1985. Who was the most recent solo female recipient of the Sports Illustrated Sports Person of the Year? It was in 2019. We played a song by the band Heart called "Kick It Out." Played David Bowie singing "Golden Years." She won gold with the 2012 Olympic team. And in the 2015 and 2019 World Cup, Megan Rapinoe is the correct answer. Our human anatomy question. What bone's name is derived from a combining of the Latin words for to stand and foot? What bone's name is derived from a combining of the Latin words for to stand and foot? Actually translates to stirrup in English. It is shaped like a stirrup. The correct answer, the stapes. The stapes. Categories, famous people. Here's the question. Identify four of the seven individuals that were nominees for Time Magazine's Person of the Year for 2022. The list included government officials, politicians, philanthropists, and entrepreneurs. Identify four of the seven individuals that were nominees for Time Magazine's Person of the Year in 2022. Are all the answers in? Number one, we played a song by Billy Idol called "Rebel Yell," a reference to Secretary of the Treasury Janet Yellen. Number two, we played a song called "See You Later, Alligator," A reference to the current governor of Florida, Ron DeSantis. I think that was Bill Haley in the Comets singing that. Number three, we played a song called San Francisco by the artist Scott McKenzie, a reference to Mackenzie Scott, the ex-wife of Jeff Bezos. She's a philanthropist. Number four, we played a song, that was Chubby Checker's version of Back in the USSR, a reference to Volodymyr Zelensky. Number five, we played The Pretender singing Back on the Chain Gang, a reference to former U.S. Representative from Wyoming, Liz Cheney. Number six, we played George Strait singing All My Exes. Singing about All My Exes, a reference to the President of the People's Republic of China, Xi Jinping. First name, X-I, pronounced Xi. Xi Jinping was number six. And finally, we played The Electric Boogie by Marsha Griffiths. The Electric Boogie, a reference to entrepreneur Elon Musk. Here's question 16. In the category vehicles, according to Car and Driver, the top-selling vehicle in 2022 was the F-Series Ford pickup truck with over 653,000 units sold. What vehicle was number two? All right, question 16. Vehicles, according to Car and Driver, the top-selling vehicle in 2022 was the F-Series Ford pickup truck with over 653,000 units sold. What was vehicle number two on the list? We played the song Truckin' by the Grateful Dead. We played Perry Como singing about Silver Bells, a reference to the Chevy Silverado pickup truck, 513,000 units sold. Question 17, authors. Here's our author's question. According to the website Owlcation, owlcation.com, what pseudonym tops the list of, quote, famous names that are actually pen names, end quote? According to the website Owlcation.com, what pseudonym tops the list of famous names that are actually pen names? Question 17, authors, according to the website owlcation.com, what pseudonym tops the list of famous names that are actually pen names? Played a Canned Heat song called Future Blues, a reference to the dystopian themes often contained in this author's works. We played a song by Simon and Garfunkel called At the Zoo, a reference to this author's work called Animal Farm. George Orwell was the correct answer. Pseudonym George Orwell, born Eric Arthur Blair. There you go. Question 18, Holliston. If any team gets this question wrong, they'll have to leave the premises immediately. According to Wikipedia, Holliston is the only town in Middlesex County that borders towns in both Norfolk and Worcester counties. Name them. According to Wikipedia, Holliston is the only town in Middlesex County that borders towns in both Norfolk and Worcester counties. Name them. We played a song by Millie Vanilli, a reference to Millis, which is in Norfolk County. We did not play a song clue for the town of Medway, which we also accepted. Thank you very much. I was prepared to call security on a few of our players. Thank goodness we avoided that. And we also played a smash by singer Lita Ford, a reference to Milford, which is in Worcester County. All right. Here's question 19, commerce. What restaurant's TV ad slogan is "Happy tastes good"? Here's our commerce question once again. What restaurant's TV ad slogan is "Happy tastes good"? Okay, question 19, commerce. What restaurant's TV ad slogan is "Happy tastes good"? We played a song called "Sunshine of Your Love" by Cream. We played the exciting instrumental by Henry Mancini called "Snowfall," a reference to the delicious blizzard, which you can find at Dairy Queen. The Team Queens have 63. The Team Queens have 65. We have an update, 65 for the Team Queens. Stagecoach Trailblazers have 76. The Goats have 68. The Visitors have 96 first place, and Friends of Holliston Trails have 63. Question 20 is in the movies category. We're going to ask you to bid between 2 and 20 in even number denominations. Half your bid will be deducted from your score in the event of a wrong answer. Here's your question in the movies category. On the American Film Institute's list titled 100 Years, 100 Quotes, which was published in 2005, it features the top 100 quotations in American cinema. Which non-human character is the highest on the list at number 15? On the American Film Institute's list of 100 Years, 100 Quotes, published in 2005, it features the top 100 quotations in American cinema up to that point. Which non-human character is the highest on the list at number 15? At this point, I'm going to ask our friend Heidi Gibson to come up front for the awards presentation. Heidi, come on now. Here's question 20. On the American Film Institute's list of 100 Years, 100 Quotes, published in 2005, featuring the top 100 quotations in American cinema, which non-human character is the highest on the list at number 15? I believe that was Perry Como, "Home for the Holidays," David Bowie's "Space Oddity." Correct answer, E.T. is the correct answer at number 15. And we have prizes tonight for our top two finishing teams. We'd like to acknowledge all of our players in fifth place tonight with a score of 66 points. Let's hear it for the Stagecoach Trailblazers. Yes. Well done, well done. In fourth place tonight with a score of 83 points, the Friends of Holliston Trails. There they are right there. In third place with a score of 85 points, let's hear it for the Team Queens. Our second place team with 88 points for the Goats. Where are the Goats, please? There they are, second place. And first place. You ready? Okay. Can't wait to come back next year. Don't forget to invite us back. Our grand prize winners with 100 points, the Visitors. They're right over there. Congratulations to the Visitors. Thank you for coming, everybody. Thank you, Heidi and friends. Thank you, everyone, for participating. Thank you, Monique, for scorekeeping. My name is Bob. Let's do it again next year.